Hello, my name's Andrew Jones. For a while now, I've been looking at the free energy machines on YouTube, on the internet, and I've seen that there's a lot of controversy, a lot of argument, a lot of conflicting opinions about what works, what doesn't work, what won't work, etc. So I figured what I would do is create a build of a attempt to make a free energy gravity fed electricity generation machine. So it won't be a solar machine, it won't be a wind powered machine. I'm not even sure if I want to even add one single solar panel. I'm not sure if I want to add even a wind turbine or what have you to it. I think I want to prove out the concept initially of a gravity fed device. Now there's a video that I saw a machine years ago. This machine was a weight, let me put these down, was a weight that was hoisted in position manually. Then over the course of a couple of hours, the weight would slowly lower. Now this weight was very heavy and the distance was quite a distance. It was like 10 or 12 feet. So for it to traverse from the very top all the way to the very bottom, it was geared on a shaft, which was geared to another shaft, geared to another shaft. But it wasn't a true perpetual motion machine, because the device had to be reset every single time the weight hit the bottom. Now there's a video on YouTube where there's been some quite vicious fighting going on, and some of the frames I'm gonna put in the background. Actually, behind me right now, you'll see a frame or two of this actual unfinished machine. The guy said it's a free energy generator that he invented, but I've seen this device some years ago and much better made. But it's great to see people jumping on this type of thing. So I applaud his efforts. You know, my interest came about 2 years ago. I live in northern New Jersey, and what happened was there was a really bad storm a couple of years back and we were without power. I forget what time of year it was. I think it was cold, so it was getting on towards the end of the year possibly. We were without power for almost a week to 2 weeks. And during that time, because I invent, because I design, because I'm always coming up with things, I used the bathroom just now. And when I was in the bathroom, I invented something because I saw an issue. I'll do a separate video on that because I don't want to give it away. This is going to be a funny one. But I wanted to design a method that would create electricity when there was no other means. So, you know, the old wheels started turning, and I remembered this video, which was a good basic, the one behind me, a good basic understanding of a beginning point. There was a lot of finessing that had to be done on this particular method. So what I'm thinking of is I've sourced out some miniature gears. I initially drew up a design. This is a 20 tooth gear. I drew up a design, the one behind me. Now I realized as I was looking at it that some of the math was very incorrect. So the gearing was correct, but the weight needed to actually, because here's the thought. A weight through gravity, pulling the weight down, pushing the weight down, however you want to look at it. It rotates because of the cable. It rotates a master gear. That gear is then geared to a smaller gear, which you end up, like the image behind me, through gearing, ends up spinning a spindle on the very end and here's a dilemma. I gotta look up the actual RPMs and what have you, but if I'm going to use an alternator I think uses about 2,500 to 3,500 RPM before it will even start generating enough electricity to recharge a battery. So the weight will fall, the gears will turn, which will make the spindle on the very last geared action, it will turn that spindle at enough RPMs to turn the alternator, which does not have a zero balance load to actually turn it. You actually might need to put a pound or 2 pounds worth of force to get that thing going. So if it needs 1 pound of torque to actually rotate the actual alternator, that weight will be geared up. So you're not necessarily going to be using a 55 pound weight as in this particular video behind me. So all of that needs to be taken in consideration. Now, my thought was initially to make this device and have it so that after an hour or 2 hours, you would lift the weight all the way up to the top again, and it again would run through a cycle. The thing is, when you sleep, after an hour or two, it's going to run out and it's going to stop. It's going to stop charging the batteries. Or the range of batteries. So what I was thinking of is having a reset system, and how would that be possible? And that this is the kick, or the kicker: how to make it so that the weight would reset to the very top again, using only the kinetic energy created from the weight being lowered from the very top to the very bottom. How can you create enough energy to raise that weight back to the top? I have my absolute beliefs and thoughts on this, so I'm not going to reveal my thoughts on this in this video, because it is going to be interesting to see everyone's thoughts on it. This is where the invention part comes in. This is where I want to prove things out and do what people have suggested to see, will this work as per other people's suggestions who know? And of course, none of them have done it before. But you know, I want to see and prove this out to see, you know, what can be done. So that's it, just a bit of a teaser right now. Over the course of the next week, I'm going to start putting things together. I'll record it. So this time next week, watch out for another video in the build of the free energy gravity fed electricity generator perpetual motion machine device. Tongue twister. All right, so that's it. Thanks for watching, and come back and see the results. So I'm probably gonna have to create a playlist for this, and create a bunch of videos that prove out each and every one of the concepts that are being thrown my way. The issue might be is scaling all of this, because this is a lot smaller than this behind me. So I need to do it right, and I need to do it sensibly. And I'm gonna have to do a little bit of research just to find out, you know, what are the scaled values of something like what I'm showing behind you. What are the scale values of that? So let's see, come along for the ride. Please subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video. Thank you for watching.